So let's look at the solution to a RAID 1 quiz. We have a RAID 1 array with two disks. A single disk in this array is a 200 gigabyte disk with a throughput of 10 megabytes per second and an MTTF of 100,000 hours. And when a disk fails, we replace it and it takes us 24 hours to do that. So in a two-disk RAID 1, the data capacity is the same as for one disk. That's because both disks are storing exactly the same data, which allows us to survive the failure of one disk. The throughput when we are reading is twice the throughput of a single disk because we can issue reads to both disks at the same time. But when we are writing to both disks at once, so the throughput for writing is only 10 megabytes per second. If half of the requests are reads and the other half of the requests are writes, then in any given second, we will be spending 1/3 of a second on the reads, and we will be spending 2/3 of the second on the writes. That way we get to do the same number of reads and writes per second, it's just that the reads are twice as fast, so they take half the time of the writes in that same second. In the 1/3 of a second that we've been doing reads, we were getting a 20 megabyte per second throughput because we were using both disks. In the 2/3 of the second when we were doing writes, we were getting only 10 megabytes per second. So overall, during this 1 second using the RAID 1 array, we ended up getting a throughput of 40/3 megabytes, which gives us a throughput of 13 1/3 megabytes per second, because in 1 second we managed to access 40/3 megabytes. So the answer here is 13.33. Note that the throughput is not 15 megabytes per second, which is what we would get if we simply average the read throughput and the write throughput we would get in this array. Because if we did this, we are assuming that for half a second we are reading, and then for half a second we are writing, and thus we get 15 megabytes read and written in a second. But if for half a second we read and for half a second we write, we end up reading twice the amount of data that we would for writes. So if the workload is 50-50 in terms of number of accesses, then it's not also 50-50 in terms of time spent on reads and time spent on writes. Reads are faster, thus we spend less time on them, which is why, again, the throughput is not 15 megabytes per second. And finally, let us figure out the MTTF for the entire RAID 1 array. The MTTF of a whole RAID 1 array with two disks, we said, is equal to the MTTF of a single disk divided by 2. So this is how long we have to operate with two disks until one of the disks fails. And now, each time we have one disk failure, we need to repair it, and we said that the number of times we can try a repair until we finally experience a failure of the second disk during the repair of the first disk is MTTF of one disk divided by the MTTR of the disk. So this first factor would be 50,000 hours. This second factor is the ratio of the time to failure and the time to repair. And when we divide these two, we get 4,166.666, etc. So this is how many times can we try a repair while a single disk is working until we finally experience a repair in which the working disk also fails. And when we multiply this out, we get 208,333,333 hours. So this is a huge amount of time compared to the original disk's MTTF. As you can see, RAID 1 dramatically improves reliability. This time is about 11 years. This time is about 24,000 years. So as you can see, the reliability has improved from being able to expect data loss every about 10-ish years to something that goes into tens of thousands of years.